I've always wanted to adopt. I remember being a child and thinking about adopting when I grew up. And I think I kind of talked him into it.
Actually, I thought about adopting when I was younger. You know, I always thought it'd be cool to adopt some kids, but I never thought I'd get there.
I started hungering for another baby. And we prayed about it, and we talked about it, and we prayed about it, and finally he gave me the okay. Finally he actually said, you know, let's do this. And so Josie came to us when she was 8 months old. She's our brown-eyed girl, and she's our airplane baby.
After visiting China in 2006, we met some other couples that were adopting and really prayed about it, about a decision to add to our family an adoptive child. And Ethan has some disabilities and needs some surgery, and we agreed to adopt him last year and took him home in January, and he's ours.
When Jim and I were married 22 years ago, we knew from the very beginning that we would have many challenges regarding Jim's health due to being born with cystic fibrosis. We knew that we would need an extraordinary measure of faith in the days set before us. From the beginning, we knew that we would not be able to have children on our own, so adoption was always an option in order for us to have a family.
We got married knowing that we probably wouldn't be able to have children. The journey began then. We were just trusting and praying.
After a couple years of infertility and then miscarriages, and so we really felt the Lord leading us to adopt, so we pursued it, and we started the process in September, brought the twins home in February, which just was an amazing, very quick trip that just shows that God had his hand in it and that God wanted us to do it. And we brought them home, and the week we brought them home, we found out that Laura was pregnant. And so 8 months later, Isaac came along, so we had all three of these kids in the same year.
Her and Zach both made part of my decision. As a matter of fact, our son, Zach, already talked about adoption.
Yeah, he is married now, and he's already said that he hopes that they can have biological children, and they also want to adopt. So we'll see what Emma... I said, well, you know, your wife's got to go along with that, too. But he definitely feels like he wants to adopt.
He was born in the state of Virginia, where there are lots of different laws about private adoptions and the amount of time a birth mother has to change her mind. And she changed her mind several times. We actually had to give him back to her once, and that was one of the worst days of our lives.
And throughout all that we had been through, especially Jim's double lung transplant in 1995, we just always knew that the Lord would see us through it all, as well as had faith that he would bless us with children someday. In July of 1998, the Lord blessed us with a beautiful baby girl born in Colorado and brought her into our family when she was 1 day old. Her name had already been chosen for her by the Lord and given to us for her long before she was ever born. Of course, her name had to be Faith.
It's so cool to look back, like when you're in the middle of things, like when I was in the middle of struggling to try to have a baby and miscarrying and all that. It's hard to see what in the world God was doing, but as I look back on it, I can see that, you know, in particular, had I not miscarried the baby that I miscarried, we would not have them.
One of the parts of the process, the adoption process for China, is in the province, you pay a fee. It's a gift to the orphanage. And it's actually the biggest sum of money we've ever had in our hands in cash that we hand over to the orphanage director. It's a legal transaction. We had to sign papers, and it was witnessed. And when this was finished, we got the adoption papers, and he was ours.
Okay.
And Rob, the next day, you know, thinking about all of this, said, "It just feels like being bought with a price." And when we thought about how costly it was for Christ to redeem us, and just how significant the work on the cross is. That's something we really took with us and took away from us.
To think that God specially designed them to be in our family is just an amazing thing.
Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3 and 4 says, "Blessed be the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, just as he chose us in him before the foundations of the world, that we would be holy and blameless before him.
Every baby born is truly a miracle and a gift of life from God. But to us, adoption seems to have an extraordinary measure of God's great love for us. The miracle in adoption for us is in how God creates families, and that of all the children in the world, he chooses exactly which child or children to place in each particular family. In our adoption journey, we did not choose either one of our beautiful daughters. In fact, each of their birth mothers actually chose us by looking through many prospective adoptive family profile scrapbooks such as ours. Ultimately, it was the Lord working through the lives of these young women to bring us all together in order to create our specific family. Just as before the foundations of the world, he placed each one of us together to make us a family here on earth. Consequently, this is an earthly image of how he first chooses us in calling us to be part of his spiritual family as his adopted sons and daughters and his truly forever family. We're so thankful to the Lord for creating our family through adoption and stand in awe of how great our Heavenly Father's love is for each of his precious children.
I've always thought about adoption in terms of how God loves us and how that's how we become part of God's family. And so adoption is very special for us in that sense, in that we become a part of God's family through adoption. We're not born into it. And so they're very special to us, and just a reminder to us of how special we are to God as well.
The first one of them was chosen. We chose to adopt. It didn't just kind of happen to us. It was something we actually sought out and Christ sees us out. The second one is grafted. We're grafted into Christ's family, which these kids are grafted into our family. Their branch is now part of our family tree. And everything that is a privilege or a blessing that goes with our family is now something that they can be sharing, which is the way we are when we enter into Christ's family. Everything that he has, his power, his strength, his blessings, it's all ours.
Now, one of the beautiful things about adoption is the way our Heavenly Father seeks out us. He seeks after us.
No.
And we can see that in our family, how we went after our adopted ones. We wanted them, and they don't have to pay back any debt to our family. They don't have to work for their place in our family. They're Lindgrens, and they will be forever because we wanted them and we made them ours. And that helps me in thinking about the gospel, how God made me his, and I don't have to work for my place in his family. I don't owe him a debt. I'm his forever. No matter what.
The kids came to us, they were flawed. They had special needs beyond what typically is needed. And that's how we are when we come to Christ. And he accepts us and loves us.
A greater picture is that we didn't pursue it, but God gave it. And now that he is with us, no one can take him away from us. He will always be in our family. And that is something that is treasured and something that we take very seriously. And so the vision that we have of our adoption in Christ is kind of played out in our family. And we get to see it on a daily basis.
We want Superman.
We